like implementation.
This call is now being
And
recorded.
we also discuss about the applications of stacks, kind of, I mean, real-time applications of stacks that we discuss. And now the similar type of data structure today we are going to discuss. I mean, we can say it's a queue data structure. So similar to the stack here, queue is also a linear data structure. Is also a linear data structure. You know, the word, before I go for that, let me ask you, you know, several times we use the word called queue, and we observe the queue in many places, like as ticket counters, if you see, and you know, even the vaccination center also. Nowadays we are maintaining the queue, the public is more. So queue everywhere we find. So that's what the real-time queue is, the same we are going to implement in computers. So what could be the definition of the queue means? It is like a stack is a linear data structure where the insertions and deletions are made at different ends. Unlike your stack, where the insertions and deletions in stack, we learn that they should be at only one end, and that end we call it as a top. But whereas in queues, the insertions and deletions are performed at two different ends. So the insertion is always performed at the rear end, and the deletion is always performed from the front end. So that means there are two pointers here, two ends we'll find. Whereas in stack, you know, one end is always closed. We assume that the one end is closed, only one end is open, and from that only, that end only, we have to do insertions and deletions. Whereas in queue, we have two open ends are there, where, I repeat once again, the front end, the front side, we use for the deletion purpose, and the rear side, we use it for insertion purpose. So when we do this type of performance, and when we do this type of operations, we will find a flavor called first in first out methodology. Means what? The element which is inserted first is the element which will be deleted first. Whereas in stack, we learn that it is last in first out list. The other name for the stack is last in first out, where the element which is inserted in the last in the list is the one which will be deleted first. Whereas here in queue, the element which is inserted first is the one which will be deleted. So this is what that first in first out methodology that we find it in queue. Okay, so this is what figuratively we can understand. There are two ends I'm clearly mentioning there, deletion to be from front end, and insertion to be from rear side, rear end. So this is what about the queue's definition. Many of us, we know already. Now come to the applications. So the applications, you know, stacks, we use them in depth first search algorithm, whereas queues, we use them in one more graph search algorithm or graph traversal techniques called BFS, breadth first search algorithm, in which we use queues. So apart from that, we also use in many places of real-time computer applications, like a CPU scheduling and disk scheduling. These are very important in operating system like things. And in CPU like the scheduling things, we use the queues only. And one of the techniques is called first come first serve. So that's what about we use in queues. And queues in routers and switches, you know, networks, when we talk packets, when they arrive, okay, there we again maintain the queue instead. So thus in networks also we use queues, and used in waiting list for a single shared resources like a printer. You know, suppose if you're having only one printer and you want to print multiple documents, and in that case, one after the other, the documents will be stored in the queue. Okay, and whichever is coming first will be served first. And that means that is the document which will be printed first. And in real-time scenario, you know, call center phone systems use in queue to hold the people calling them in an order until the service representative is free. So we have seen that, suppose if you want to call Airtel service center, and if you want to call any other service center, where the service representatives, if they are busy, then the system will ask you for waiting. And once if you, all this waiting will be made in the form of a queue. And when your turn comes, your representative will attend your call. So this is what about the real time. And one more real time applications is, the planes, aeroplanes, when they are sort of flying, I mean, when they want to land, if the landmark is busy, then all the planes will form a queue. And again, the first come, first serve will be maintained. Whichever has signaled first, whichever the plane has signaled first, that is the plane which will get a turn to land. So this is what about the real time scenarios where we use queues. And this is what about the applications of queues we learned. Now let's go for the abstract data type. So we learned what is abstract data type, the queue abstract data type, where the access and deletion are restricted to first element in a sequence called front, and element insertion is restricted to the end of the sequence, which we call it as array. So I repeat. So initially, before I go for the methods which we have to discuss, or the operations which are we have to discuss as a part of the ADT, first of all we have to talk about the pointers which are needed to perform the operations. So first pointer, which we are taking it as a front pointer, I'm denoting it as, maybe you can denote it as F or something called front, and that is what the pointer through which we try to, or say, delete the element. Which element? The first element or the front element in the queue. And the element insertion to be made at the rear set. So we take one more pointer called rear pointer, or simply we can even denote it with R also. And that pointer will help you us to, or say, insert the elements at the rear side. So this is what about, naturally, because to maintain the first in first out principle, we have to go like that. Now, queue abstract data type major methods are, like as in stack, the main important methods are push and pop. And here also in queue abstract data type, the fundamental methods are, important main methods are n insert queue, which are denoting it as en queue by sending an object O. So that means the object O will be inserted, okay, at the rear side. Similarly, de queue, that is delete queue, will remove and return from the queue the object at the front. Okay, and this particular delete queue, when we are performing, an error will occur if it is empty. So that means obviously we know that if the queue itself is empty, we cannot delete any element. So at least we expect that the queue should hold one element. And if the queue holding at least one element, then to delete that particular one, okay, we take the help of your, what's our front pointer, and what are the front element that we delete it. So this is what about the delete queue. So otherwise, if the queue is empty, simply we throw that deletion is not be possible because no elements are present. So these are the two main, methods here. And apart from that, supporting methods also we have, like as size. So all these three supporting methods are not taking any parameters, remember. And here the size method will return the number of objects in the queue. And suppose if no object is present, then we throw emptiness of the particular queue. Then is empty returns the boolean value, maybe true or false, indicating whether the queue is empty or not. So the same method we use even in the stack also. And front is a method which returns the but without removing. Remember, front only will return the front element without removing. So that is important. So the front method return but do not remove the front object in the queue, and an error occurs if the queue is empty. So these are all the three additional methods that we explain as a part of the abstract data type. Now coming to the implementation, when it comes to the implementation of the queue, majorly again we implement the queue by using either arrays or linked list. But there is one more interesting thing which we are going to discuss, that by using stacks also we can implement queues. So how we can implement queues using stack, that we'll discuss it. But before that, let us discuss about the array implementation. And if queue is an array, remember, if queue, I'm denoting that array with capital Q, Saramma, capital Q is an array variable. If queue is an array with a capacity of n for storing its elements. So but the size of the queue here, I have taken the size as uppercase M. So the capital N letter is indicating about the capacity of the queue. Now to handle, as I told you, that we have to take the two pointers. So we define two variables called F find R for insertion and deletion operations. And when we take these two, with the help of these two pointers called F and R, F points to the front element and R points to the rear element. And initially, both are zeros. Whereas in stack, we know that top is a pointer which you are taken, who with the help of which we can perform the push and pop operation similarly. And there in the top, we have taken initial value as minus one. Whereas here, we take the two pointers called F and R. F stands for front pointer and R for rear pointer. And with the help of rear pointer, we know we have to insert. And with the help of front pointer, we have to delete if any elements are, of course, present. And then the initial value for these front and rear pointers to be zero. Okay. And when F and R are equal, F value and R value of the two pointer values, if they are equal, it indicates that Q is empty. So emptiness condition is that F should be equal to R. If F is equal to R, then we say Q is empty. Okay, sir. Now, any doubt, Amma? Anyone?
No, sir.
Okay,
no,
right.
sir.
So two pointers we take, F and R, initially they are zeros when we initialize the array. And n, uppercase N, is the size of the array. And condition for emptiness is F is equal to R. Now, let us go for the implementation of one by one. So the major two methods are what, sir? Add queue, delete queue. Insert queue, delete queue. So let us go for the delete queue algorithm. You know, to implement the delete queue algorithm, we know that element can be deleted from the queue if it is having at least one. If no elements are present, then an exception will be thrown stating that queue is empty. So that's what we have to keep in mind. So when I am implementing the DQ, let us see that first we have to check whether the queue is empty or not. Obviously, if it is empty, no need to delete. We cannot delete even, in fact. So if is empty, then return queue is empty. So a label or something will be written stating that queue is empty. If is empty, returns true. So I'll tell you in the next slide we have how we implemented is empty. Then if it is not empty, then of course we can delete. And when we have decided to delete, we know that the front pointer, front element only has to be deleted. So wherever, I mean, we take that F pointer and that we pass it as an index to the Q array. And after fetching F, Q of F element, that fetched element, we are storing it in O. That is what the deleted element. And once we extracted that pointer or element from Q of F, now we don't want any more. So we insert null in that location of Q of F. And we increment the F pointer, F to be moved to the next location. And whatever that we stored in temporary variable called O, that will be returned. So O is an object which is deleted. O is an object or element which is deleted from the DQ. So from the what's a queue with the help of the operation called DQ. And you know, the time complexity, nowhere again, if you observe clearly, nowhere we are using any WhatsApp loops and all. So therefore, the complexity is we go of one. And remember, is empty is a method call. Basically, we assume that method call takes only one, but sometimes you have to be careful that is empty, if that method is using any array or a complex code, then that complex code has to be calculated. But here right now, is empty is again a we go of one. Therefore, we assume that is empty method when we are calling. So method call always takes one unit of time, so primitive operation. Therefore, the total anyhow is the required time is what big O of one. But before I go for the insert queue algorithm, again I want to ask you the total number of primitive operations are how many? Be ready for this. Tell me, Amma, how many total number of operations are there in this delete queue algorithm? DQ algorithm, DE algorithm. Yes, Amma. Just tell me the total number of primitive. The time required is big O of one because, you know, it's a constant time. But I want the clearly that number of primitive operations, how many are there in that algorithm DEQ? Yes, Amma? Anyone?
Eight, sir.
8. How 8? Let us see. I mean, there are again two cases, Amma, that we have to consider, minimum and maximum. Tell me first of all that minimum operations are how many? Or minimum primitive operations are how many that algorithm takes?
Two, sir.
Minimum how many, Amma? Someone. Minimum number
Two.
of op. 2. Aisha, you only answered, no?
Yes, sir.
2. Yeah, why 2? Because is empty is a method call, and if it is true, then the remaining operations will not be performed. Directly, a return statement only will get encountered, and we come out of that delete queue method.
Yes,
And the
sir.
return will take one primitive operation. Is empty method call will take one primitive. So total number of primitive operations minimum are 2. Now tell me maximum how many primitive operations that algorithm will take? Maximum. Minimum is 2, I agree. So what about maximum?
8, sir.
8. How 8? Let us see. Is
First is
empty method
assignment.
call? Okay, you tell me, Amma. Yes, first assignment, okay.
Indexing, then again indexing, assignment, again assignment, increment,
Okay.
and is empty conditions, and return of zero.
Okay, so fine.
The O,
Let us
sir.
start. Okay, fine. Let me count. Now is empty from top to bottom. I'm coming. Is empty is a method call. So that takes one primitive operation, Amma. And if it is false, we come to the remaining operation. So is empty is one primitive. Assume that it is false. Now we come to the next statement called Q of F, which we are assigning to O. So Q of F is the array indexing. Assigning O is nothing but the fetched element to be assigned to O. So there are two primitive operations. So till now, 3 we got. Now again, null to be assigned to F, Q of F. So Q of F is array indexing, and to that in fetched element, we have to store null. So that means again assignment. So here also there are two primitive operations. So let me write one by one here on the screen. Here is what. So O is equal to Q of F. So the Q of S is what? Indexing. And this indexed value to be assigned to O, so assignment. So thus here in this one there are two primitive operations we have. Then again at Q of F the location we are storing null. So that means Q of F is indexing again, and in this fetched indexing value we have to store null value. So assignment is one more. Here also in this we again have two primitive operations. So likewise two are over. Then comes we have to go for F is equal to F plus 1. So here in this statement, how many primitives are there? Let us count. F plus 1 is arithmetic, single arithmetic one. So one primitive operation, and the resultant value to be assigned back to F is assignment. So this is one more. So 1 plus 1 again here also in this, we have two primitive operations. And lastly, we have return statement, and return always go for one primitive operation. So total till here are how many? 6 plus 1, 7. And but before this, you know, is empty is a method called. Isempty is a method which is called. So method call also will take one primitive operation. So thus 7 plus 1, total 8 primitive operations. This is what maximum, Amma. So maximum 8 primitive operations, and minimum is 3, sorry, 2 primitive operations. Okay, so this is what about, anyway, in both the cases, whether it may be 8 primitive operations or 2 primitive operations, both are of constant time. Therefore, finally, what we declared is the time required for execution of delete queue algorithm is big O of 1. how big of one, I told you that already. You know, if anybody is having doubt that how we are writing big of one, rather we got big of 8 or big of 3 means, if someone is having any doubt, I can explain, which already I did it in the last class. I explained it how whenever we get constant, we directly write as big of one something. Now that's about the algorithm about delete queue. Let us go for the inserting an element or object into the queue. So for that, algorithm is enq by passing O as an argument. Now we know that we can insert the element in the queue only if it is not full. If the queue itself is full, then we cannot insert the elements. So that's what the basic everybody knows. When there is a space, then only we can insert something. So that we have to verify first, and if it is having space, then only the object which we have passed as an argument to be inserted. So let us see that. If R is reached to N, R means rate pointer, and we know that with the help of rate pointer only one can perform the operation called insertion. And we are talking about insert queue only. So but if R, the pointer R, is already reached the array size, then obviously it is an indication that queue is full. Observe carefully, we are going to discuss some interesting point about this particular algorithm. Okay, similarly, even DQ also. Okay, certain limitations are there in this simple array based implementation of queue, that we'll discuss it. But right now, we know very well when R reaches to N, if rare pointer is pointing to the total size, then it is an indication that queue is full. If not, then what we do, we have space, so therefore at the rareth place, at the rareth location, rth location, we can insert the object. So we take the object and we insert at the rth location, and then we increment the r value. So this is what about the insert queue operation. Okay, now all of you, so tell me about again the complexity is big O of one only, but around that the minimum and maximum number of primitive operations, how many it takes for this insert queue algorithm, ENQ algorithm?
Yes, ma'am. Minimum is 2, sir. Minimum is 2, maximum is 5.
Very good. Again, minimum is 2 because R is equal to N is a comparison, and if it is true, then return queue full is return statement. So there are only 2 primitive operations in that. So minimum is 2. Now let us see the maximum here. If R is not equal to N, that means if the rare pointer is not reached to the maximum size, then we come to the execution of the other 2. So in executing the other 2 statements, both statements will take 2 primitive operations, because assigning the object O to the rth location of the array means array indexing and then assigning. There are 2 primitive operations in that. And the next statement called R is equal to R plus 1. In that, again, we are adding, first of all, 1 to the rare pointer. And that we are assigning to R. So there are, again, 2 primitive operations, total 4. But R is not equal to R is equal to N comparison is 1 primitive. So total 5. Maximum 5, minimum 2, as she said. But in both are, again, constant. Therefore, in general, we say the time required is big O of 1. This is what about the insert queue algorithm. Now the other additional algorithms goes like this. We know that emptiness, already told, the condition for emptiness is whenever F and N are pointing to the same location, then we return true. If F and the front pointer, F and rear pointer are pointing to the same location, then it indicates that it is empty. So we'll see that, you know, we'll trace the algorithm, don't worry. So if it is the case, then we return true, otherwise we return false. So again, very simple, no need to discuss the big O of one, no loops we are using here, any no complex code that we are using. So finally, all our primitive operations, therefore, the time required is big O of one. Now front algorithm, you know, front algorithm always returns a front element, but it returns front element when there is an element in that one. If it is empty, no need to return. So that's again, we have to check while using the front method, while calling the front method, we have to verify whether it is empty or not. If it is empty, simply we display the message queue is empty. Otherwise, we return the front one. So again, big O of one, and come to the size. is r minus f. If we simply perform the operation called rear pointer minus front pointer, whatever the subtracted value is there, that itself indicates about the size of the size of the cube. Okay, so these are all the three additional methods here we have. But let us discuss about these two operations which generally we perform by taking a simple example. So here is what I'm assuming, that this is my cube. Having four elements, Amma, therefore size n, capital N, is 4 here for me. And here these are my indices 0, 1, 2, 3. And you know, already I told you that at the very first stage, F is 0, that is front pointer is 0, and rear pointer is also 0. So thus F and R are pointing to the same location, that is 0th location. And you know, this is what the place where is completely empty. So what we do, let us start inserting. But before inserting, intentionally I'll try to do the operation of deletion. So assume that I want to delete, and the name of the array is Q. I want to delete the element from Q. So I'll call the delete Q method. You know, what is the delete Q method? Okay, first we have to check whether it is empty or not. If not, then we can delete it. So if is empty, then return RET empty. Otherwise, what we do in the object O, whatever the front element is there, that we store. And then, okay, in the location of F, we store null. And then we increment the value. This is what the delete operation. And insert operation is, if R is equal to N, then return Q full. Q is full. Otherwise, what we do, we insert at the rareth location, that is Q of R is equal to O, and then R to be incremented to the next location. These are the operations which we perform while doing the insertion. So insertion is simple, and of course deletion is also. These are the two operations that we have to check. Now intentionally I will delete first. We know that Q is empty, nothing is there in that. So if I call delete Q, if I call the method delete, let us see. It will go to the is empty. And is empty, we know what that is empty methods are. What that is empty method, how it is implemented. If F is equal to R, it returns true. When it returns true, if F and R are holding same, if they are holding different values, then return false. This is true, Amma. So I repeat, if both F and R are same, it returns true. Otherwise, it returns false. So all these three methods that we'll discuss now one by one. Intentionally, if I first time call the delete one, then it will go to the delete. And in the delete method, we have first of all verification of isEmpty method. Now isEmpty method, it will come here and we'll check F and R values. What is F and R initially, Amma? Initially.
Zero.
Zero. Here is what an initialization stage. I'm observing carefully. This is what the initialization state. So both F and R are holding zero. So condition is true. It returns true. So here we, this delete operation has received true here. So upon receiving true, it will not perform the remaining three operations. Rather, simply what it will do, it returns empty message. So yes, sir, Q is empty. So likewise, you call any number of times the delete operation, it always throws empty only. So obviously, you have to go for the insertion. So assume that in the second time, I'm calling insert method of inserting, say, A. A is a character which I want to insert in the queue. So So it will come here and will check the R and N value. What is R, sir? Initially, right now R is what? R is what?
Zero.
Yes. Here is still zero only, Amma. So R is zero and N is, you know, four. N is four. So both are not equal. It will come here to the remaining two statements to execute. So Q of R is Q of zero, and Q of zero in which we are storing A. So thus in the zeroth location, A will be stored. And then, okay, after inserting the object O, next statement is increment the R value. So R will go for R is equal to R plus one. So R will be incremented because R initially one, now adding one, resultant is one. So thus, the next stage is, this is what, initial stage. Initial stage. Now after inserting A, the new stage looks like this. Array is the array, that is Q, holding the elements A and remaining are zeros or nulls, where F is zero but R is changed to one. Observe. So this is what the updated one. Now in case if I call once again that insert something called method with passing B, insert B, let us go here, and in the insert method again it will check R value with N. What is R right now? Currently one, and
one
N is four,
Amma. Equals to four.
Yes, Amma. So what it will do, B will be inserted the Rth location. So R is what?
One.
So at the location one, B one will be stored, and then R will be incremented. So R gets incremented to one two. Plus one, that is two. So thus here, at the second time when I am calling, insert B, your array status looks like this. Q is an array holding A and B with F is equal to still zero only, but R is reached to two. Onakala. Okay.
Yes, sir.
So this is what the fresh statement. Let me write. Q with the status A, B, and the other two are null, 0, 1, 2, 3, with F 0 and R 2, R 2, R 1, 2. Two together? And N is how much, Amma?
2.
N is 4. Total capacity is 4. Now, once again we call, third time we call, insert C, say something. So here again we have to check if R is equal to N. Is R is equal to N, Amma?
No.
No, R is 2, N is 4, so not equal. So what we do again, at the Qth Rth location, we insert C. And then we increment the R value. So thus we have what? C here at the second location. And then we increment the R value. As a result, R will become 3. Then once again, if I call, why I'm continuing like this means I want to check whether full condition is arrived or not. So D is what the element which I want to insert. And again, we verify is R is equal to N. R is 3, N is 4, not equal. So therefore, at the Rth location, D we insert, and then we increment the R value. So thus, here, R is 3. So Q of 3 in which we store D, and then we increment the R value. That is, what's up? 3 plus 1 is 4. R is 4. Now, once finally, here again, I want to say insert F as an element. But here, if condition now gets true, because R is 4, N is also 4. As a result, here we get a message that Q is full. As I know, we get every time the message Q is full. So this was the status. Now what I will do, I will go again for the deletion now. So let us delete an element. delete queue. So if I call the delete queue, it will verify E is empty. No, E is empty, sir. No, it is not empty. We know that because R is not equal to F. Because R and F are not equal. F is 0, R is 4. So what we will do, we delete that element. So to delete that element in object O, we store Q of F. So front element, whatever is there, that we store it in O. And we increment the F value. Before that, you know, in the Fth location of the Q, we store null. So this operation also we perform. So these are the three operations we perform it if it is not empty. So since F is not equal to R, it is not empty. So therefore, the object, I mean Q of F, whatever object is there at the Fth location, F is 0 among all of you. So at the Fth location, we have A that we store it in O. So O is holding A. And you know, we increment F value, but before that, we store null. So thus, the array looks like this now. Here we have null here, and B, C, D are there. And this is what that A which is deleted. After deleting, F will get incremented. It will come 1, and R is 4. And you know, already the capacity of Q is 4. This is what the first time when we delete. So, of course, whatever the front element is there, that only is what the deleted. That is, A is the one which is inserted first in the queue. So it is the one which has to be deleted. So the same thing is happened here. That element A is what deleted. Then again, if I call delete queue, DQ, then the same, you know, F is not equal to R because F is 1, R is 4. So again, the same three operations will be performed. F to location, that is first location, whatever that we have, that will be deleted and will be stored null here. And F gets incremented, so F will become 1 plus 1, that is 2. This is what the second term when we call. And the third term when I call DQ, delete Q, again, F is not equal to R, because F is 2, R is 4. So we again delete the Fth location element. So F is 2, so whatever the second location element is there, that we delete it, and we increment the F value. It is 2 plus 1 will become 3. And then again, fourth time, once again, if I call delete Q, so F is 3, R is 4, not equal. So we delete the Fth location element. So what are the front element called 3, that will be deleted. And in F, we store or we increment F value, that is 3 plus 1 will become 4. And then once again, here we call DQ, say. So DQ, once again, if I call, F is 4, R is also 4. So F is equal to R. Therefore, what it returns? E is empty.
E is empty.
E is empty. Okay, Namma. So this is what about the two operations. And now onwards, whenever we call DQ, delete Q, every time it shows that it is empty because F is reached to 4 and R is also reached to 4. Kani, observe carefully. Suppose if I call insert again, but before that, let me redraw the queue status. Null, 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 null. Zeroth location, 1, 2, 3. N is 4. N is 4. Remember, F was 4. R is also 4. Now, what I will do here, I will try to do insertion of all of you. Try to do insertion of something called E. E is an element which I want to insert. So, when I'm trying to insert here, insertion is possible if it is having place. So for that, initially checks the condition is R is equal to N. What is R, Amma? What is R right now?
4.
N is what? 4. Both are true, therefore it returns what? Q is? What it returns? Full. Q is full. But you see, observe that Q is not at all full. It is having a lot of space. All four elements are available, basically. But whereas, bad luck is that your rare pointer is reached to the last. Means it is already crossed the index and reached to the size of the array. Now onwards, whenever you insert any element, you know, not only this situation, you know, say many, say for example, already this is also one of the situations. This is empty, assume that, but here we have say B, C and D. Here rare is 4, size is N 4 and F is 1 amma, remember. Here in this situation, F is pointing to the first location, R is above the index, equal to size. Now in this situation also, if I try to say insert E, if I try to do the operation insert T, insert E, the element E, R is what? R is equal to N. Again, the condition is true. Because R is 4, N is 4. And it throws what, sir? Return? It returns what? Q is?
Q is full.
Prati, sir, in all these cases, Malli inkoti. But basically, in this case also, you observe carefully at the back side, a space is vacated. At this location, space is vacated. And we know that this is not the case where Q is empty. Sorry, Q is full. We know it is having a space. At least one element we can store, because one to store one element there is a space here. But what is happening here when I'm trying to insert it, it is simply throwing that it is full, because already R is reached to the size. Even if this is also deleted, F will reach towards R 2. That means two empty spaces we have at the back side. But still, in this situation also, it shows that if I try to insert, it shows that it is full. Ila, in all these cases, every time whenever I try to insert some element, backside we have empty space basically, but because of already the R pointer, rare pointer is reached to the size of the array, every time it throws that Q is full. This is what the very important limitation that we observe it in simple array implementation of Q. If I do the operation of array implementation of Q, this is what the major disadvantage that we observe it. Okay, Namma? Because we have to fix the size here, you know, it's a static array. So size has to be fixed, because that's why I called that it is a simple Q, linear Q, simple linear Q. So how to overcome this situation? We know that there are plenty of spaces there. In the first case also, all four elements are deleted. After deleting, the queue is completely empty. So we have four elements, okay, which we can store. But when I'm trying to call the insert element, it is throwing that queue is full. Exception, it is throwing, stating that it is full. Not only that situation, wherever we have empty at the back end, where the front pointer is deleting the elements, in that situation also, we have observed that R is already reached to the size of the array. So every time it throws that Q is full. So how to overcome this situation, Amma? This is what very important observation, limitation of linear Q implementation. When kali aitundi, rare pointer ka artham kavatledu. Rare pointer is already reached to the dead end. And you know, the checking condition for inserting the element is that whenever R is reached to N, whenever the rare pointer is equal to the total size of the array, then the exception will be thrown stating that Q is full. So how to overcome this scenario, Amma? All of you. How to overcome this scenario?
Sir, linked list we can use, sir.
Of course. One solution is that, and it is a dynamic. No, once if you say linked list, obviously it will become dynamic. In this case also, dynamic array, if you take, you know, once if the size is reached, once if the rare size is reached to the total size, rare pointer is reached to the total size, immediately we increment the array size and we again start performing the insertion operation. But we waste a lot of space, Amma. Okay, if you use the dynamic array, you can solve, but lot of space will be used because at the back side, when deletion will start, your front pointer will go on delete the elements, and that rare pointer will not know at the back side what is happening, how many elements are deleted, with how many empty cells are created after deletion. This information is not known to the rare pointer. So even if you try to implement by using what's a dynamic array, some extent we can solve, but we waste lot of memory. So one solution, as she said, that we can implement it by using linked list here. But there is one more. I don't want linked list. I want arrays to be used, the same arrays by using which we have to effectively utilize the space which is vacated at the backside by the front pointer because of the deletion. And that is what the birth of the new array called circular, so new queues called circular queues. So you imagine that the queue, instead of imagining that queue is linear queue, you imagine that your queue is circular queue. So the same array implementation, static array only, by taking which we can effectively handle the problem which we faced in linear array. Okay, Nama? Okay, Rama. So to overcome that one, we have to go for the circular queues. That's what the birth, why circular queues are introduced, means this is the case where circular queues will be used here. Okay, so how circular queues, that's what the same thing I explained, Rama, that under the note here, I explained all that when, in which situation the problem arises. So as a note, I explained it. So, and to overcome that limitation, we have to go for circular queues. So in circular queues, no need to change any condition, Amma. Still, the empty condition is f is equal to r. Whenever f and r are pointing to the same location, it is an indication that your queue is empty. But coming to the other operations are, we have to rotate circularly. That means, you know, how we have to do this means, I'll come again here. You know, let me take three elements only this time. N is three for me. Zeroth location, first and second. This is my queue. Both F and R are initially zero. So if I try to insert here, insertion is possible if it is having at least one empty space. That means if it is not full, and the fullness is if R reaches to N, but here the fullness is different, I'll tell you. So what I'll do, I can insert A, say at the zeroth location. And now when I'm inserting, what I have to do is I have to do that R is equal to R plus 1 mod N. This is what that operation I have to do. So what is R, Amma, initially?
Zero initially,
but after inserting A in the zeroth location, R has to be incremented. Na? So, in simple case, what I did, I simply incremented stating that R is equal to R plus 1, but this time the incrementation is slightly different. So, what I have to do is modular incrementation. I have to do how means R plus 1 mod N. This operation I have to do for implementation. So, R is initially zero. After inserting, it has to be incremented by 1 mod size of N is what? 3. So 1 mod 3. What is 1 mod 3, Amma? Mod operation will return the remainder, Amma. So what is 1 mod 3? What is 1 mod 3 in C language?
0, sir.
Is that 0 or 1? 1 by 3 is 0, Amma. 1, 1, remainder kada ma, mod n is remainder ma. So 1 mod 3 yes, is 0 sir, yes, times sir. It will go, it will return 1. So that means R is holding 1 ma. So thus R is incremented by 1. Now once again, if I try to insert, so obviously at the 0th location R to insert, Q of R is equal to B, say, and then R has to be incremented. So at the 0, Q of R is 1. So at the first location we insert B, and then again we increment R, stating that initial value is r plus 1 mod 3. So this is nothing but 2 mod 3. What is 2 mod 3, Amma? 2 mod 3.
2.
So r is not 2. So thus we inserted b. Now I want to insert one more at the rth location. Say it is c. So what is current r value? 2. So at the 2th location we insert c. Then after inserting we increment r value, stating that r is equal to r plus 1. So what is r is equal to r plus 1? That is r plus 1 mod 2, sorry, 3. That is nothing but current r value is 2 plus 1 mod 3. That is how much, Amma?
R equals to 0.
Yeah, mod 3. That is 3 zero. Mod 3. What is 3 mod 3? 0. So 3 mod 3 is 0. So chudandi em ayyindante after inserting ikkade aagipoledu, no, r is not equal to 3 now. Intaku mundu adi aagipindi, it has stick struck to the maximum location. Now what is happening here, r is reset to the zeroth location. After reaching maximum, after reaching to the last index, it will reset to the zero. So reset kante mundu, assume that, no, this is what the reset location where we have f is 0, okay, r is 0. Now to delete this one, what we do for the deletion also, we do the same. F is equal to not f plus 1, rather f is equal to f plus 1 mod n. Is good m h undi zero location delete aipothundi. So then your this will become,
sir,
one. Then one location
equal to...
No, I'll tell you, I didn't discuss about the emptiness. I'll tell you that also. I'll tell you, don't worry. Just I'm telling you about the deletion now. I started explaining about the deletion operation, Amma. Okay na? Okay. I'll tell you about that, the condition, other condition for this one. Let me perform the remaining actually. So let me see that how deletion we are performing. Again, we are not doing simple f is equal to f plus 1. Rather, we do f is equal to f plus 1 mod n, Amma. So in that case, again, what happens here? F is initially 0. So 0th location element will be deleted. Then f will get incremented. It will become 1. And the 1 location element also we delete it. Okay. And then again we go for the next one, there we delete c. So likewise, and again when we try to delete, it will reset to the beginning. So what I'm trying to say, once if it is reached, is coming back, Amma. So as a result, we say it is looking like we are performing the circular operations. Maximum kelintra, that means you go on, reach to the maximum, and then again come back. Again you go on, reach to the maximum, then come back. So that means what we are doing here, we are performing the operation in the form of what, sir? In the form of what? A circle. Yes or no? So circular operations are performing. So related to this here, these are the operations. Okay. Now E is empty. And what, sir? The other operations also. What are they? Insert Q and E is empty, same. F is equal to R. Here we didn't change. But I think we change what? The size here. We change size here. Okay. All of you. Size is not R is equal to N. This time the size is N minus F plus R mod N. N minus F plus R mod N. There in that case, the size is R minus F simply. So these were the size. And this size, of course, we used here in delete queue. Sorry, what is that? Insert queue. In insert key, we use that operation. If this may affect that operation of f is equal to r, Amma, all of you. Okay. Okay, all of you. You see that size operation in the previous algorithm was r minus f. But this time, the same size operation, this time it is not r minus f. Rather, it is n minus f plus r mod n. This has to be verified for the fullness. ఓకేనమ్మా మీరు వచ్చిన డౌట్ చూడండి ఆర్ ఈజ్ ఈక్వల్ టు ఇఫ్ ఆర్ ఈజ్ ఈక్వల్ టు ఎఫ్ that still remains same for emptiness, but before that it is circulated, we have to check the size method return value with n minus 1, not even n. If the two are equal, then we say q is full. Okay, Nama?
Yes, sir.
Now use this one. All of you use this one since we have only 5 minutes left. So these two methods you copy in the meantime and trace that one with the help of the size method. Okay, and recheck. I repeat once again, is empty, I didn't change. Still, if f is equal to r, then we say it is empty. You see that one, wherever the things are happening like that, whenever r and f are pointing to the same location, then we say it is empty. And initial values of f and r are set to zero only at the very beginning, even in the case of circular queues also. So I didn't change the condition for is empty, but I completely changed the method of calculating the size, which returns the number of elements which are present in the queue. And this may change the operations which we perform for insertion as well as deletion. I explained this one to just state about how circularity will achieve. The circularity achieved with the help of this modular operation. So once if R and F are reaching to the maximum size, they drop and come back to the zeroth location. So circularly, the pointers will go on continuously rotate. And whenever at the backside, if any space is generated, that space will be utilized by these two pointers for insertion as well as deletion. So this is what you check these two, and if not, we'll continue in the next class from this particular algorithm implementation only. Amma, if any changes are there, we'll do it. In the meantime, my advice is you better you check the implementation of these two algorithms. Right? Okay, Amma, all of you.
Yes, sir.
If you want,
okay,
you note
sir.
Down
yes,
this size related particularly, and these two algorithms, which to delete queue and insert queue. The size is n minus f plus r mod n. Ikkada kuda modular operator we are using. And that size method we are using it in the insert queue algorithm, enq algorithm. If size is equal to n minus 1, then return q is full. Okay, Nama?
Yes, sir.
Those you all note down, just roughly trace it because they are very simple algorithms. After, don't take complicated size of array, sir. Just take the simple array with the size of 3 or 4, then implement these algorithms, trace them properly, and if any problem is there, we'll discuss it. So this is what about the queues operation. I mean, both linear queues and circular queues are explained at a stretch. So why circular queues is born because of the limitation that we observed. Okay, Chandrika madam, are you there, madam?
Yes, sir.
I'm winding up, Amma.
Yes, sir. Thank you, sir. Thank you so much.
Thank you, madam.